another video. I hope you are doing very well. Today I'm feeling very excited because I am finally back with a what I eat in a day video. I feel like it's been so long since I did one of these, and they are my favorite videos to film and edit and all of that good stuff. So yeah, I'm stoked to be here. Despite what it may look like, it has recently turned winter here in Australia, and although it is relatively warm in this very moment, the mornings and the evenings have been quite brisk, for lack of a better word. So with that all being said, this is what I eat in a day as a vegan in winter, and all of these recipes are very tasty and nourishing, and they warm you from the inside out. With that all being said, let's get into the video. This is what I eat in a day, and I hope you enjoy. So to start the day at 8 a.m., we are making some coconut yogurt oatmeal. Warm oatmeal is something that I have recently introduced into my diet, and I'm loving making on like really slow starts to the day. You know what I mean? Anyway, to start this recipe, we're first of all boiling some water. I'm boiling about a cup of water in total, and then I'm also adding in 1 cup of quick oats into the saucepan with it. Then I am mixing it all together, and as you can see, it gets this really nice, like, for lack of a better word, gluggy texture. Then after it's been cooking for a few minutes, I added in 1/2 of a mashed banana and also a heaped tablespoon of vanilla coconut yogurt to make it nice and creamy, just the way I like it. Once it had been cooking for about 10 minutes, I then served this into a bowl. I also added in some green apple as well as 1/2 of a banana chopped. I then added some homemade almond butter, which I am obsessed with at the moment, as well as another tablespoon of vanilla coconut yogurt and some sunflower seeds on top. This is a breakfast that I have been really, really loving, and I'm finding that it keeps me very, very full because of the amazing amount of healthy fats that is in this meal. We all know I love a good healthy fat on this channel, but yeah, that is what I had for breakfast. Moving on to lunch, and we are making a cauliflower and tomato pasta. Cauliflower, in my opinion, is one of the most versatile vegetables. You can make so many amazing things with it, and one of the things that I love making with cauliflower is a pasta sauce. To make the sauce, I first of all cut up 1/2 of a head of cauliflower into relatively small pieces, and then I put it into a saucepan with some boiling water. I cooked this for like 1/2 an hour. I want the cauliflower to be as soft as it can possibly get, and as you will see, there is like a lot of water going on in here. We want to get the cauliflower nice and moist. Once that was all cooked and cooled, I then put it into my Vitamix with the juice of 1 lemon. I then also added in 2 cloves of garlic. Spoiler alert, I ended up adding a 1/3 clove of garlic. I love garlic so much. I also put in 3 heaped tablespoons of tomato paste, as well as nutritional yeast to taste, paprika again to taste, and then I also added in some pepper and some Himalayan pink salt, which I love. To make the sauce nice and creamy and to make sure it blends, I then added in some soy milk. This is something I just eyeballed and made sure that it was going to be thin enough so that it would all blend together in the Vitamix. As you can see, it has a really, really creamy texture once blended. Then I used this San Remo chickpea pasta. This isn't sponsored, by the way. That looks so sponsored, but it's not. This is just my favorite pasta. You can get it from the supermarket here in Australia, and it is gluten-free. I cooked it up until it was really, really nicely cooked. As you can see, look at that dreamy pasta. I drained it, and then I put it back into the saucepan, and I added in our creamy cauliflower and tomato sauce. Oh, this is so, so delicious. I love pasta so much, especially in the winter months. I then served this all into a bowl. As you can see, this is a lot of pasta. I like to eat a lot for lunch. Actually, I just like to eat a lot all the time. Anyway, I put some nutritional yeast and some paprika, as well as some salt on top to serve. If I had it, it would have been really good with some breadcrumbs as well, but yeah, that's what I had for lunch. If you're a regular viewer of my channel, you will know that I always love to have a sweet afternoon snack. And at the moment, I'm loving drinking hot cacao, specifically this spiced cacao by my friends at Amazonia. You guys know I love Amazonia so much. To make the spiced cacao, I very simply in a saucepan put some soy milk as well as 2 teaspoons of the cacao mix, and I mixed it around until it was nice and warm. Very, very simple. There's something really nice about making hot cacao over the stove. Then I poured it into one of my favorite mugs, and this was a really, really nice and sweet and chocolatey afternoon snack that kept me nice and warm while I did some editing on my computer. As you can see, I'm enjoying it very much, so shout out to Sinead in the background. You go, girl. A couple of hours later, it was time for my dinner, and I'm making a warm greens bowl, nourish bowl, kind of fun thing. I just like to eat a lot of roasted vegetables at the moment. First of all, I'm chopping up one small sweet potato into, you know, bite-sized pieces, as well as half of a block of adzuki bean tempeh. If you're a regular viewer of my channel, you'll know I love tempeh, specifically the tempeh by Organic Village, because it's not soy-based, it's like other bean-based. Anyway, I'm putting my sweet potato and my tempeh onto a baking tray with some baking paper, as well as a head of broccoli. Broccoli, one of my all-time favorite vegetables, and I'm absolutely loving it roasted at the moment. Before I roast it, I just drizzled some olive oil on top, and then I also put some salt as well as some pepper on top as well. Here you could add other spices if you like. Personally, I love to put like nutritional yeast and paprika. But yeah, the beautiful thing about vegetables is so many different spices go well on them. I roasted these in the oven for about 30 minutes. My new oven in my new place is amazing. Roast vegetables so quickly. And whilst all of the vegetables were roasting away, I got onto one of my other favorite vegetables, which, you guessed it, is kale. I love kale so much. I can't believe I spent so much time not eating it. This is about half of a head of kale, which I just put into my frying pan with a little bit of olive oil, and that is it. You can also add salt, spices, nutritional yeast, other fun things. I was just feeling something really, really plain this evening. So this is what I went for, and once the kale was all fried up, I then put it into a bowl. We have a huge bed of kale in tonight's dinner, and then I added on top my roasted broccoli, my roasted tempeh, as well as my roasted sweet potato. On top of that, I then also added on some sweet chili and lime dressing, which I'm loving at the moment. I love a good sauce. And that is what I had for dinner this evening, and concludes what I ate in a day. Yeah, this was a really, really beautiful day of eating.
Alrighty, my beautiful friends, so that is what I eat in a day. All of the full measurements and recipes will be down in the description box below if you want to try any of them out. If you do try them out, make sure to tag me on Instagram. It is here. You can check me out there. And yeah, as always, thank you so much for being here. I appreciate it very, very much so. And I will see you so soon for another video. Have a beautiful day. Bye.